Hey, Out Late But Great, this is Jim here from Ohio, and it is Friday, and I am your host on Fridays on the channel Out Late But Great. So anyway, guys, I'm sitting out here, and it is just another beautiful, beautiful day up here. It's just awesome. Blue skies, I have to mow the grass. So, but anyway, the topic of the week, and I don't have it with me right now, but it is something like this. If you're in an elevator and you are carrying an LGBT publication or book, and you're in the elevator with someone that your gaydar thinks is straight, would you say something to them if you had a chance or whatever? Well, first of all, my gaydar, I told you before, is broken. I can't tell who's straight, who's gay. I really, really can't. So, yeah, you know what? I think I would. I've done it before with other things, not so much with books. This happened not too long ago. We were on a bicycle ride out on a bike trail here in Ohio, and two guys got in the next car, got their bikes out, and they had a rainbow flag on their bumper. And so I'm like, oh, cool. And again, I had no clue that these two guys were gay. But I'm starting to think that maybe there's a lot more gay people out there than we think. So anyway, I said, hey, nice sticker. Well, they just started laughing. So we chatted a bit. And it was fun. It's kind of a way to meet people, I think. I did it once too. And I talked about this in a video that I put it on my own channel last year. We were at a market on the west side of Cleveland, and I had my Human Rights Campaign t-shirt on. And we were just standing there, and a woman tapped me on the shoulder, and she said, hey, I'm a PFLAG mom. Well, if you know what PFLAG is, that's Parents and Friends of Lesbians and Gays. And she said, you know, my son is gay, and he's been out for a couple years now, and we're still dealing with it, so we go to the meetings. You know, and I said, oh, that's really nice, you know. And so I introduced her to Dave and everything, and we had a nice little chat. I've done it before too, like even in airports. I do have another t-shirt from the It Gets Better campaign, which I'm sure a lot of you know about, the Dan Savage thing for kids that are being bullied. And I was in the Cleveland airport with it on, and somebody tapped me on the shoulder and said, you know, nice t-shirt. And so we started talking. I think it's kind of a fun way to get people talking and to meet other people. I really do. So yeah, I would definitely, you know, I'm telling you guys, at this point in my life, I could care less. I really could. I think once you cross that 50-year mark, it's like, who cares? You know, I am tired of living my life for other people. I really am. So yeah, I would do that. So anyway, guys, I have to tell you something else that's really kind of sort of exciting, kind of weird in my life. A woman that I know, you know, I'm a radiology tech, right? And a woman that I know also is a radiology tech, and she works at a prison. So she is always having a hard time finding people to replace her when she goes away on vacation. So she asked me last year, I think it was. So I said, sure, I'll give it a try. I've always thought of prison life as to be kind of interesting or fascinating or something. So, but anyway, you have to go through all these checks. They take your fingerprints and your urine drug screen and all that. Well, I guess I passed, and I got my ID card. So this week I've been filling in for her just a few hours, you know, during the morning. And boy, what an experience that is. I had never been to a prison before, and it's just a whole different world. It really is. It's just, you know, I could not stop thinking about, you know, how did those people get there? You know, why them and not me? You know, if I'd been born into a different household or whatever, you know, and if I had different role models, then, you know, would I be there too? And it's a whole different atmosphere from working in a hospital, because in the hospital, your patients are your clients, your customers, they say, and you're supposed to be really, really nice. But in the prison, it's not that way at all. You know, in the hospital, if I had a chest X-ray on a John Smith, I'd say, you know, Mr. Smith, come on, come with me. But there, it's like, they don't want you to do that. They're like, it's just like, Smith. So, I don't know, after 30 years of being nice, it's kind of hard to be mean. But I'm not going to be mean, because I can't judge them. You know, I have no idea why they're there. And like I said, you know, if things had been different, yeah. So that's all I really have to say. This is the holiday weekend, but unfortunately I have to work on Memorial Day, so that kind of stinks. But we're still going to have fun. We're just going to goof around and do some stuff around the house again. So anyway, guys, that's all I have to say. I will talk to you next week, and take care. Love you guys.